Take two, take two. Welcome to Music at Noon. Batteries, that's too loud. Greg, turn 13 down a little bit, please. Thank you. Batteries required. Have you ever heard that before? How's your battery doing? All right. Okay, it's amazing what the tuning A will do to quiet down the audience. You were having so much fun, and then they started tuning, and no more fun. Anyway, welcome to Music at Noon. It's great to have Camellia City Flute Choir back again. They have been entertaining you since 2011. And Marty Melicharek is the one who makes this work because he put together this very unique choir. Why is it unique? All flutes, and the flutes range from the length of a long pencil to the height of the ceiling at your house. And you'll see them, and they're going to demonstrate all of the flutes in the flute family today. But Marty Melicharek has put together an amazing flute choir that you will not probably hear in your lifetime anywhere else because there are so few of them in the United States that incorporate the contrabass and the bass flutes. So that's your special treat, and he has some music on here that is amazing, that works so well for his flute choir, and he's arranged many of the pieces. So that's what we have today. I hope you enjoy it. Please welcome Camellia City Flute Choir.
Our first number today is called by Kells Waters. It is a Celtic folk song, and we really like this arrangement. I hope you do too. Thank you. I should tell you that we just love playing here because you are such a wonderful audience. Thank you for being here and being with us. Our first suite features soloists from throughout the orchestra. There isn't a person in here who doesn't do solos somewhere. It is truly a group of magic flutists, and Marty manages to pull us all together and make music. The first soloist on the suite antique for playing the prelude is Irene Warschauer. For the ostinato, and by the way, that's not the name of a car, it's an ostinato, which means a repeated low frequency tune. The soloist is Francesca Anderson. We will play the last half of this suite later in the program.
Thank you.
You may not know this by its title, The Sorcerer's Apprentice, but most of you probably have seen or the replay or the original of the wonderful movie that featured Mickey Mouse as the Sorcerer's Apprentice. Well, you will hear and see in your imagination all those kinds of things that you remember from seeing that Fantasia movie eons ago.
Thank you. There, am I on? Yes. Ah, good. Now it's time for I get to introduce our instruments. This is the fun part of my concert, because we happen to have instruments that you don't usually see in bands and orchestras, but are quite unique to the flute choir ensemble. So let's start with the biggest ones, and we have the super big one, the super big daddy, the big plumbing, which is the subcontra, and it's in keyed in G, and plays about 2.5 octaves below our C flute, and then the regular contras in C. So let's give you a sample of what they sound like, going down the scale from C. And we could let the subcontra go down 4 more notes, but. Ah, there we go. And these are the true basses in our ensemble. So the tenor voices happen to be the altos, or the bass flutes, and you can see that they're only about 3 feet long. And they have a nice mellow tone, and we're seeing more of these in a lot of ensembles, particularly in the jazz genre. So let's give a sample here. Nice mellow tone. Next we have the altos in the group, and these are quite useful, at least in the jazz genre. And now we see in a lot of more modern orchestral music the use of the alto flutes. And if you'll raise those so we can all see them. And you'll notice that some of them are straight and some of them are curved, and it depends how long your arms are. It depends on which one you end up buying. So can we have a sample of what they sound like here, please? And of course, now the last two instruments that you're most familiar with is our C flute, which is the concert flute. And can you start in the middle of the staff and go up, please? They can go in the opposite direction. Now go up for us. Okay. Good example of the C flute, the concert flute. And then finally, our little instrument, the piccolo, which is about the size of a very expensive pencil. Anne, could you give us a sample of that? Yeah, okay. And most of you are familiar with John Philip Sousa's Stars and Stripes and the piccolo solo. Well, that's the instrument. There are other instruments within the flute choir community that are more unusual and quite a bit less common. There's actually one instrument that's still bigger than this one. It's called the double contra. It's 16 feet long, and you have to play it on a stand that you have wheel it in to the concert, and I think you get 4 notes per breath on it. Kind of questionable usefulness, but we just recently had the International Low Flute Festival, and it was interesting to see what everybody was doing with the new ideas about how to use these wonderful harmony instruments. Anyway, next on the program, Mary Reed.
If you have a program, there is a slight typo. This next composition, or series of compositions, is from the balcony. It's not just the balcon, balcony. And the composer, Kathleen Mayne, wrote 7 little short pieces describing all of the characters as she was sitting on the balcony. There are seven of them. The second one is called the Relief Critter, and some people know it by Katie did. Then there are seven of them, and we'd like to ask you to hold your applause until we have finished all seven.
Thank you.
Thank you. Aren't those fun? I think my favorite is the Mourning Dove. I heard them this morning, just before we came down for the concert. Anyway, this next piece is called the Serenade, And the story is that the composer was writing this for his wedding. And for when the wedding closed, he didn't want all the people to be walking out in lockstep. So he wrote this with very unusual time signatures. Sometimes there's 13 beats in a measure, sometimes there's 11. You just never know. And so it's great. You could not possibly walk in lockstep to this one, as you will notice. And for the final piece that's on the program, we have soloists Pat Walton and Kirsten Price.
Thank you.
Thank you. You've been a great audience today. We've enjoyed playing these works for you. We have one more piece, and most of you are my age in here, so it should bring back some fond memories. It's called Puffin' Billy. Does anybody remember what that's from? It was the theme song from Captain Kangaroo.
Marty, you know how to put a smile on her face. And Camellia City Flute Choir. You're amazing. You're all individually expert and professional quality, and that's what makes you such a tight ensemble. And you bring us really happy pieces and very interesting pieces for this unique ensemble, which is not easy to arrange music for because you have to work with certain tone qualities and make the music transparent. And you know how to do it, Marty. Not very many people know how to do that. So you need to start publishing your music. Thank you very much, Camellia City Flute Choir. And Mary Reed, please stand up and thank you very much. And if you are a soloist today, please stand up. And if you are a member of the Camellia City Flute Choir, please stand up. They will next charm you in December. And they will have charming seasonal music for you. Next time you're here, you can hear Irene Saito. She was last here playing piano for you 5 years ago before COVID. And then when her time came around, it was COVID and she couldn't play for you. So she'll be here and you can go to your smartphone or your computer and put in musicatnoon.org and scroll down to the music section and you'll see the program for next week. It includes some Chopin. I think you'll enjoy it. Hope to see you then. Take care. Bye for now.
I didn't know you were coming. Thank you.
Welcome
you
home.
Hear, you get to hear it. I know. You get to see, hear the same concert when we do it at the Heritage Park.
Oh, yeah.
It was the Captain Kangaroo.
Oh.
Yeah. Marty didn't say it very clearly. But, yeah. That was Kangaroo. Yeah. Captain Kangaroo. That program was on. I looked it up because I thought I was going to have to say something about it. It was on from 55 to 84. So it was over.
55, I was 5 years old and watching that.
Yeah.
I think it was Art Linkletter, and I thought,
No. It was, had to do with kids. You were right. Yeah. I heard them this morning. They did a great job. Thank you for coming. All right. Yeah, I love your book. I want to write whatever you want about it. I think it's great. The thing that you had on Facebook or whatever, I wrote a comment.